Ana Paula, thank you for being here. Really excited to have this conversation with you.
Thank you, Vikas, for the invitation. Great to be here.
As we're wrapping up WEF 2025, what have been some of the key themes that you've heard in the course of the discussions you've had this week?
You know, it's very interesting because this is my fourth Davos. The first one that I came, it was all about crypto. The second one that I came was all about metaverse. And the third one was all about AI. And the fourth one is all about AI. So I think that it's very clear that now leaders understand the impact that the technology is going to have in their businesses. But looking at it from a much more thoughtful perspective, how can I really get ROI from AI? How can I make sure that I minimize impacts around compliance, security, the aspect of sustainability of AI, lots of discussions around the impact of energy consumption on AI and the developments that we'll have to do around that. And a lot of conversations around the quantum as well. So I think that those are themes that are becoming really part of how companies are thinking about their future going forward.
And speaking about quantum, Ana Paula, IBM is a leader in automation, in AI, in quantum technologies. What can leaders expect to see in from IBM from a technology perspective in the course of the coming year?
We continue to be very committed to our roadmap. Our target right now is by the end of this decade to have quantum with capacities of 100 million gates, for example, and that is really what is going to allow quantum utility to become a reality. And Vikas, the reality is that in the past few years, we have been delivering every milestone of our quantum roadmap. So that's, you know, that continues to be our commitment. We have recently announced the expansion of our quantum infrastructure around the world. We opened a quantum data center in Enningen this year in a great partnership with the government of Germany. So I think that we are going to continue to see a lot of evolution in terms of quantum hardware, quantum tools to develop application. And finally, one area that is becoming more and more a source of concern is how you prepare your data for a quantum moment when cryptographies can be broken by quantum computers. So there is a lot of investment as well in us helping clients to assess their data, the exposure that they might have for that scenario, and how we can prepare for that.
Ana Paula, you spend your time with business leaders in Europe in particular, helping them get value from technology. What are some of the themes that you've been hearing from them? What would be some of the advice that you would have for a business leader that's looking to get the maximum that they can from their technology deployments in the coming year?
Well, the reality is that the IT environments have become extremely complex. And while a few years ago, people were still a little bit doubtful if hybrid cloud was going to be the architecture of the future, I think that today we can absolutely state that this is the reality. We have applications running in multiple clouds, in on-premises environment. And what companies are looking for right now is ways to make it more effective, cost-effective, and simpler to manage. So I think that we have been advising a lot clients in that sense and providing technologies that help them have better visibility of their IT environment and make it more cost-effective. So that's point number one. Point number two, clients have already realized that for them to get true benefit of AI, they have to use their own data. So having the data ready, you know, governance of how they are, you know, using their data to tune the models to make them more specific to their applications is another area that you're seeing significant progress. And finally, I think that the great evolution of AI going forward is going to be on the topic of agentic AI, where AI is going to be used really to automate workflows inside companies, eliminating a lot of inefficiency and giving people more time to focus on, you know, value-adding activities, creating new products, innovating for their clients.
Terrific. One last thing, switching gears a little bit. What would give you the most hope and optimism for the coming year?
I think we are living in a moment where there is a very clear understanding of what technology can do to progress society. So we need to continue to making those investments. But at the same time, we have to balance innovation with responsibility and sustainability. We cannot, take those elements out of the equation. And I think that this is what we're going to be continue to focus at IBM. Make sure that we have innovation, but at the same time that it's responsible.
Responsible innovation.
Yes.
Ana Paula, thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Vikas.